first question that I would like to ask you is, so being like belonging from this NBFC, which plays a very vital role in the flourishing economy, do you think that this budget has lived up to the expectation of NBFC sector?
Well, I don't know about lived up to the expectation, but I think the budget has some very huge positives for the NBFC sector. First of all, I think is the sort of vote of confidence from the Honorable Finance Minister, acknowledging the role that NBFCs play, have played and continue to play. So that itself, I think, was a very major step, positive step. And then, of course, there were specifics in terms of the 1 lakh crore first loss guarantee, which the government said they will pick up 10%. Then there was also some changes on the taxation side. So overall, I would say after a long time, the finance minister has sort of focused specifically on the NBFC sector. So overall, we would say very positive.
So as is the theme of this entire conference suggests that there are some unfinished agendas.
Right.
So can you throw light on those unfinished agendas?
Yeah, the major part of the unfinished agenda is to make sure that there's an institutionalized framework to support the growth of NBFCs. Because as I think has been repeatedly said, the last mile credit delivery in this country, especially to small businesses, small traders, small transport operators, that is essentially done by the NBFC sector. And for the economy to grow, and ours is a consumption driven economy, and for the economy to grow, you need a robust banking sector, you also need a robust NBFC sector. So essentially what we're saying is that this is a relationship of a wholesaler and a retailer. The banks are the wholesalers, the NBFCs are the retailers. So if there is a good institutional framework whereby credit can be delivered to the last mile, it's overall good for the economy. I don't think we should just make this about what's good for the NBFCs. I think it is more about what's good for the overall economy, for growth of the automotive sector, for growth of MSMEs, that whole thing. And NBFCs play an important role in that growth. So I think that's the perspective in which we need to appreciate this.
So moving on to the next part, the entire crisis was started after the IL and FS defaulting in September and after the Diwan Housing and Finance Limited.
Correct.
So how do you see this? And you, like in this meeting, that one fact came out is that we can't generalize this crisis.
Exactly.
Can you throw light on that?
No, no, absolutely. You said it yourself. I mean, ILFS happened in, I think, August or September 2018. We are now almost at the end of July 2019. We are still talking only about the same two names. ILFS, DHFL, ILFS, DHFL. So you please tell me, there are nearly 10,000 NBFCs. Have you heard any other name defaulting? So I think you have answered your own question. Essentially, this was a problem concerning two entities. Please fix those entities. You know, don't condemn a whole sector because two people did something wrong. So that is the answer. The fact that nobody else has gone into default, the fact that no one else has created any other problem itself is the answer to your question.
So what are your future expectations? What would you like, want the government to do?
Well, we would like this confusion and some of this negative sentiment towards NBFCs to settle down very quickly so that people can get on, NBFCs can get on, the rest of the economy can get on, and all the segments of the economy that we serve, they can also get on with it. So that is our expectation, and hopefully it happens sooner than later.
Thank you. Thanks
very much. Thank you.